and missed all the excitement and euphoria from the opening 2 days of the Rugby World Cup. It's easy to forget about the teams like Samoa and USA, who are on a real dogfight to take the top spot, two spots, and hope for that dream of knockout rugby in a couple of weeks' time. Hello everyone and welcome along to Cornflakes Group, your home of Rugby Challenge 2 and the 2015 Rugby World Cup. Now, match of the day, another couple for you all today, spoiling the fans for the Rugby World Cup. What more can I say? But Samoa is up against the United States, two sides in a tough battle to even look like scoring a top two finish as well. Samoa have pulled all their big guns out for this one as well. Plenty of names you'd expect for a first 15 from the Samoans. They'll be relying on their inspirational number 8 and captain Trimaranis to lead this team around from the back of the forwards. In the back line, there's plenty of talent, plenty of X-factor as well, with Fotuli'i, Tusi Pisi, Ray Lilo, Paul Perez, Alassana Tuilagi, Ken Pisi on the right, and of course their newest recruit, formerly from New Zealand, Tim Nanai Williams, an excitement machine for the Samoans at the back. The United States of America have had a really tough build-up to the Rugby World Cup. Plenty of matches against the Canadians and Pacific Nations Cup, where they really had a big pile of dogfights there against the other sides as they kept trying to better themselves ready for this competition. Plenty of professional representation as well, and they'll be relying on big men again. Number 8, Samu Manoa, will be massive for USA in the backs. They'll rely on their wingers as well, the likes of Wiles and Nguinia, and in the backs for the halves, Petrie and McGinty are two that are rising up the ranks. Petrie, very experienced, but he needs to help out his man outside him. McGinty needs to direct the side around with his boot. Can he rise up? He's got a tough ask against the ultra-experienced 2CPC as well. This one could be a cracker through the 80 minutes. Let's get down for kickoff. We are set to go. USA up against Samoa. Now, Samoans will be in the blue and white. It is the Americans who will be in the blue and white as well, but quite contrasting here. Samoa to kick off, if it's too confusing in the colours, we are ready to go. Match up between Samoa and the United States of America. Massive points on offer here for one of these two sides in the match of the day for day 3 of the Rugby World Cup. Release. USA pull the ball down and they'll have it for the first time. Petrie has a bit of a run himself. Release. And is drilled to the ground just outside his 22. Now they'll look to use their forwards, and Fingalago goes wide, and here's a big chance as well. Panamo did well nicely, away to Kelly, who puts the kick in. Downfield it goes to Tim Nanai Williams. Look out, don't let him run too far. For Tuilagi, great pass to him. He breaks through open space. Wide he looks for Tikanui. He's got the open ball to Perez. Perez takes down two, and will lose the ball to Nguinia. Now the Americans coming back, and it is Manoa running round in circles. No one keen on tackling the American captain. He's still going. Finally gets the ball out to Fry, who does a brilliant job. Look at them go, the Americans. Turutalu was absolutely extraordinary there. Three massive runs, and now they lose the ball. Perez, 2CPC, straight to contact. What a match this has been already between these two very flamboyant sides. Short side run for Al-Saliva, trying to charge through, but a good tackle from Finoglio. The American hooker drags Al-Saliva over the touchline. We'll have our first set piece of the day. All just taken from Hayden Smith at the front. Now they'll look to their back line. Palomo again goes deep down to Kelly.
Release.
And a massive tackle. Read it like a book to the Samoans. Fry, Manoa. Big ball wide and Nguinia. Oh, good tackle, Talofa. Oh, he takes it off him as well. What a play there from the loose head prop. Big tackle on Nguinia in a turnover. Now here's Petrie looking to Fry. Fry offloads Kelly in some space. Again on a 22. Ops to kick it downfield. Tim Nanai Williams will look to spread his wings. Oh! You just waited for when he might step in field, and Anguinha said no. And he's got a yellow card. Well, we've seen it all tournament long already. The yellow card's such a massive part of how this tournament's going to go. There's been flying them out the door as the kick from Pixie is extraordinary. And Tusi Pixie rakes off an absolute pile of meters up to the 22. He's gone. Three-man line out is the call for Samoa. 20 minutes in, USA yellow card, of course, Anguinha. Fotuli throws it out the back door, no one for Osuliva Lamb. Picks up on the ground, Tusi Pixie. Away for Ray Lilo. He's got the gas, he's got the experience too. Goal, great offload. And Ken Pixie will be in for the first try. Samoa strike first. Ray Lilo straight through a hole. Beautiful offload to Ken Pixie. And we've just about got all three of the pieces out there for this one. Just two, Tusi and of course Ken. But this was a brilliant play from Ray Lilo. The offload, the pass, exceptional behind the defensive line play from Samoa. And they've got the first try of the match and they take an early lead. That was exceptional play. What a pass, but the pickup was even better from PC out wide. Well, the first try goes to one PC. The conversion will go to the other. An important 2 points early on this match. The yellow card has already proved to be a massive part of this game. Tusi Pixie gets a beautiful kick and it's another two. It is 7-0. Samoa lead USA. Back to halfway for America. And back to halfway for McGinty. Kicking back off, he goes left side. The Samoans all tricking back. America attack. But Falso Saliva gets a beautiful away. Pixie has knocked the ball on. Kicked ahead again. And again it's kicked on. But the Americans surely will come back for this ball. They do. They're playing with advantage. As now they'll look to spread it through the back line. But McGinty goes to ground. Advantage has seen them go backwards. Here's Manoa. Good ball away. And a good chance. Oh, Panama. Oh, that is beautiful. And Palomo has just about gone all the way himself, but Tim Nino Williams shuts him down with a high shot. And speaking of high shots, Anguinha makes his way back onto the field. Yellow card for a high tackle. And he comes back. High tackle from Nino Williams. And here's something ambitious. McGinty is lining up a shot for three from an absolute mile away. This is just never gonna go over. This is a massive kick, and of course it is 20 meters short. 2CPC away for Tuilangi, and that was a great tackle coming across. McGinty the one responsible for that. Fasil Saliva away for Lilo. Ken PC, he's got one already. He's looking for another. Great tackle. Excellent work from Scully at fullback. Samoa recycle, and look at this, it's a 2CPC looks to the skies with his box kick, and it's just gone into the 22. USA call mark, and it's Petrie, the scrum half, who's gone back to pull that in. 5 minutes to go until the break. They tap. McGinty goes away for Durutalo, and he gives it to Palomo again. He's a strong runner at inside center. He's chopped down. To run from the hooker, Fonoglio.
Release.
He's taken down inside the 22. Samoa attacking in defense. Petrie goes short and they cut wide now. Oh, Wiles has been hammered. Look to shimmy and field. He got the full face of that. Manoa goes nowhere. A hospital pass from Petrie. Now it goes to McGinty. He's knocked that on. And we will have a scrum feed, surely, to the Samoans. USA, a dreadful job of getting out of their own 22. Well, they're never going to get anywhere. Playing that short to the fly half was never going to be advantageous to them at all. And now the scrum feed, Samoa right on the halftime whistle. Can they put a little dagger in the back of the United States? No, they won't, because USA have blown them straight off the ball. Petrie just has to give it to someone to kick out. And Guinea cuts him field. Palomo does well. Advantage Samoa. It's caught in there by PC. Advantage is over. They've got it back eventually. Perez. Oh, poor Perez. He steps and it goes all the way. What a try. Samoa get number two. That's what he can do from outside center. Poor Perez. We've seen some great work from him in the past. This time, just add to it. Great work from Fotuoli. Perez went outside Palomo and he steps around Scully. And in the tackle of McGinty, he goes over for the try. Great work, Samoa. Expected to go wide, but it didn't happen. And Perez showed he's got the ability to bulldoze his way through, score the second try for Samoa. Well, a great first half from the Samoans. Here is Tusi Pisi to add the extras. He's nudged it wide. Not the result he was looking for there at all, but it's still 12-0. It is Samoa leading the USA Eagles at halftime. Plenty of action on display here for the fans who have packed out the stadium for this matchup. We can see it as the Samoans who have dominated all the exciting factors of this match. Possession 63%, territory 81%, tackle count, despite those dominating stats from the Samoans, is still pretty even, 21-22. USA just making one more tackle in the first half. The big one though, handling here, is 3-2. Probably the most interesting stat, with neither side making too many mistakes, USA making a couple right at the end. Other than that, they have been pretty much flawless through the first 40. Can they come back though? That's the big question. Samoa have dominated this one so far. What does the second 40 have in store for this real arm wrestle of a match that has crucial points in it for one side who will go and increase their chances of going into the second round of the competition? Back to halfway for the USA Eagles. McGinty will thumper this one quite high and extremely deep. A great kick, just doesn't quite find the support. Samoa throw it out to no one and Paolo has to come and jump on it. Now they'll get the nice, oh, big tackle. And Takuri has to jump on it outside his own sticks. The Samoans under huge pressure, but Tusi Pisi, cool as a cucumber, straight out of the fridge, has beautifully kicked that away. At the back there is Scully, who will run it. Oh, can PC now steals it back. Here's Trinoranis, the captain, the big number 8, runs away. Fotuoli picks up his loose pass and he is completely isolated from his team. Fry away for McGinty and he's kind of looked for the corner here. Missed it completely. Beautiful work. Tim Nino Williams offloads to see PC Lamb away for Paulo again. He looks to charge through. One tackle. He did a great job there. Oh, Samoa. Numbers aren't there for them at all. And McGinty looks wide. His options and numbers are there. Wiles back and failed. Knocked on. And there's another mistake. McFarlane has spilt his marbles there. Now they go back to Tusi Pisi. Inside is 22. Hammers this one away and Scully scampers across looking to pull it in. Just outside is 22. Up to Nguyenye. Oh, great pass. He's just picked up inside the halfway line. Oh, knocked on now from Fotuoli'i. And surely that's into touch and we will go back for the knock on. What a little passage of play there. Both sides throwing the ball around.
Crouch.
Eventually it ends up a scrum, but the kicking, the chasing, the tackling, the passing, everything is quite a high standard between two teams that, you know, you wouldn't maybe expect to be at this high quality. Samoa have shown their increased development over the years as America come wide. And Wales 2-on-1 overlap goes for the kick. That's going to go dead and goal. Big mistake from Mr. Experience on the left wing. Well, he looked for the option. He had the overlap as well. He should have taken it because Samoa have come all the way back over halfway. These two sides both showing huge improvements over the last 4 years. America getting the numbers, getting the population base behind them. Trivoranas, he'll run this out for Samoa, finding Lilo. Oh, Lilo knocks it on. And another mistake from the Samoans.
Release.
Get out of jail. Free card almost here for America. The Eagles look through Kelly. Gives a short ball back inside and a great run there.
Release.
And Lemisitani goes through a good 10-meter run. Here's McGinty, bang around the corner. And it's there for Manoa going wide for Aguinha, who gets no opportunity. Hammered into touch again. He's just not getting the service he really requires out there on the right wing. A full seven-man line out here for the Samoans as they look to attack again to the back and land for Fotolii. Fires a wide for Lilo and the absolute defensive line parts on the Red Sea and he's taken out late as well. Saved by Wiles and he hammers this beautiful kick up towards halfway. But how about that defensive line for Ray Lilo? Cut in half, beautiful running, and then the late tackle as well. The ref is just not onto this at all. Five-man line-out for Samoa. Fotuli again and Lamb. This time he takes a battle. That would have been a great pass. Could have just about linked up. And it would have been a massive hole. But USA have stolen the ball, intercepted. And once again it's that man Palermo who's been just in everything for USA. Petrie. Oh, misses on out. Gets it away to Wiles. Wiles looking for space and time. Can't get it away up there on the left. Still ball here for the USA. Short pass, nicely done for Peterson. Oh, the pass to McGinty was superb. Petrie, left side, beautiful ball. McFarlane again, and Peterson to Wiles. Held up from the Samoan defenders. They look to charge him into touch, but they don't get away. Manoa, once again, Peterson, beautiful pass. The Americans surely will be in here. Palermo can't get the finish. USA just 2 meters short. They look to the big man, but McGinty will score. USA hit the board. It is a fly half, McGinty, that gets the try for USA. The Eagles are on the board. And it was a good period. I thought Palermo, how close can you get? Should have scored it himself, but the beautiful pass. And in he goes, good pass from Finoglio. The hooker gets the offload away. And this is great work from the Eagles. This is what we know they can do. They've taken some time, been a bit rusty, as have all the teams. But the great finish, the try for McGinty. And he is in. And he has a chance to add another couple to his tally. With a kick at goal from right in front, and it is just what they needed as well, because now they have an opportunity with a deficit of just 5 points with 5 minutes to go. It's 12-7, Samoa just lead this one. 4 minutes on the clock. Samoa need to just get this ball and kick it out. 2CPC gets it underway. A deep kick as well, putting the Americans in their own territory. Great tackle on Kelly. Oh, Samoa have turned this over. There's still a couple of minutes on the clock. And Tikori through the heart. He goes, oh, he offloads to PC as well. Release. The skill of the second rower is phenomenal. What have they got in store here, Samoa? They've got their hooker playing scrum half, and he does well. Lilo over the top to Ken Peasy. He's taken. Great tackle. And Wiles turns over. Now it's the Americans running away with numbers to left side to Wiles. And Wiles is chopped down. Oh, the time and the clock is up against them here. But Samoa made the mistake of not holding on to the ball. USA. Away it goes for Petrie's hammered. and turnover ball to CPC. He's got numbers wide. It's Tuilagi. Tuilagi. Bingo. One out of the way. Away to Takori. Oh, they've not done it again, Samoa.
Release.
Perez could have got that ball. They want the try here. The Samoans. Can you blame them? Trevoranis. Oh, it's numbers to burn. And got to be a try. Out there for Ken PC. He's got two. And Samoa deny the Eagles the bonus point. Well, you got to think about it this way. That is very clever from Samoa. They've denied the United States a bonus point for losing within seven, which, given how close the second place in this pool could be, that is huge. Effectively, they've given themselves a fifth point against the Eagles just for this try, just the second. It was numbers, but let's, for a second as well, commend the Americans' defense. The Eagles have been sublime. Their defense, even at that point, when they looked like there was a three or four man overlap, they still almost covered all but 1 meter of the width of the field, which is very good defending. America will be a force to be reckoned with in the future. They have shown great signs of development here already at this tournament. The Samoans have got lucky, but they escape with a 12-point victory, 19-7, over the Eagles. There is full time. The result, not a surprise, but the performance from the Americans was better than most would have expected. They've shown that they are good enough to compete on the world stage, the Eagles. They look disappointed, and they may well should as well. They've put in a good shift here, determined on defense, and at times very creative on attack. 19-7 the final score, 12 points the difference, 3-1. But you have to say defense was key for the Eagles. They'll be able to come away and not concede a 4-try bonus point as well. The game was close. It was very close, and USA right at the end even could have stolen the victory with that last gasp chance to Wiles. He was good, Wiles, made a couple of mistakes, but was key to their attack as well. His experience is priceless for the Americans. Here's the point scorers as well. Samoa, 3 tries, Perez with 1, and Ken PC with 2 from the right wing. Exceptional finishes as well from Ken PC. 2CPC was the goal kicker. He got 2 from 3 for the Samoans. As for the USA, McGinty with 1 try and 1 conversion. Their only point scorer, but really, there could have been a whole lot more. Well, the full-time possession and territory stats didn't change a huge amount from what we've seen at the halftime break. 59% and 66% possession and territory respectively going to the Samoans. Of course, the yellow card for the Americans would have disappointed them. That's when they conceded the first try of the match. But both teams, despite the difference in possession stats, have got exactly the same amount of tackles, 47 apiece. So a great matchup between these sides. Exciting rugby from the Samoans and the Americans, but it is Samoa who take the 4 points into their pool for this beautiful result. One they had to win, but one that could have been a big banana skin for the Samoans. That is my time for today's match, done and dusted. As I said earlier, there will be a second match of the day for day 3. We will have the All Blacks up against the Pumas, New Zealand, Argentina as well from day 3. So stick around and stay tuned for that. Won't be too far away after you've watched this one as well. So thank you everyone for tuning in and watching. Hope you're all enjoying the Rugby World Cup series. We have plenty more matches, plenty more discussions to come as well. So stick around, stay tuned, hit that subscribe button, give the video a like if you've enjoyed today's match. And I'll see you all next time. Until then, take care.